Hi everyone, it's Emmett from Pie My Life Up. In this video, we will be showing you how to set up Spoolman on the Raspberry Pi. Spoolman is a really neat self-hosted web service that allows you to efficiently manage your 3D printer filament. It even has tools built into it so it can automatically update your filament usage as it's used by your 3D printers. Even if your 3D printer isn't supported, the web interface makes adjusting values incredibly easy. You can even use the Spoolman web interface to generate QR codes that you can paste onto each of your reels to better identify them within the management system. The Raspberry Pi makes a great place to host Spoolman because it is very efficient to keep running 24/7. And if you're already running a software such as OctoPrint, it is the perfect companion tool, especially since it can get the filament usage directly from the OctoPrint software. For this guide, we will be using a Raspberry Pi 5. However, Spoolman will run on anything newer than the Raspberry Pi 3. You don't even need to be using a 64-bit system, as Spoolman comes with 32-bit support. Now, before we begin installing Spoolman onto our Raspberry Pi, there are two things you will need to have done already. First, we highly recommend that you set a static IP address for your Raspberry Pi. This will make accessing Spoolman significantly easier in the future, as the IP won't continually change on you. If you haven't set a static IP before, we have a guide in the description below. Secondly, you will require Docker to be installed to your Raspberry Pi. This is very easy to install, and we have included a link to a guide in the description below. Once you have everything ready, open up the terminal on your Raspberry Pi or connect to it using SSH. Let's start the installation process by updating the package list. We can do this by typing in sudo apt update and pressing enter. After the package list is updated, upgrade any out-of-date packages by typing in sudo apt upgrade hyphen y and pressing enter. Next, we need to ensure that the wget package is installed to your Raspberry Pi. We'll be using this package to download the Docker Compose file for Spoolman. Ensure wget is installed by typing in sudo apt install wget and pressing enter. We can now create a directory where we will store the Docker Compose file for Spoolman on our Raspberry Pi. This same directory is what we will use to store Spoolman's database and its configuration files. Create this directory on your system by typing in sudo mkdir -p /opt /stacks /spoolman /data. We now need to ensure that the slash data part of this directory is owned by the user with the ID 1000. If we don't do this, Spoolman will run into permission errors when it goes to start on your Raspberry Pi. All we need to do to set this permission is to type in sudo space ch own space 1000 colon symbol 1000 space slash opt slash stacks slash spoolman slash data. Now change into the directory we just created by typing in cd slash opt slash stacks slash spoolman. Now we can use the wget command to download the compose file that will set up Spoolman on our Raspberry Pi. To do this, you'll want to type in sudo space wget space https colon symbol forward slash git.pymylifeup.com/compose/spoolman/compose.yaml. With the file now saved to your Raspberry Pi, we'll want to edit it so you can see exactly how this file will be running Spoolman. Begin editing this file by typing in sudo nano compose.yaml. In this file, you can see that we declare a list of Docker services, with the only one in here being Spoolman. We reference the Spoolman image directly from their GitHub, and we use the latest tag to ensure we always get the latest release of Spoolman on our Raspberry Pi. Next, we set the restart option to unless stopped. This ensures Docker will continue to restart this container if it crashes. After this, we specify our one and only volume. This ensures that Spoolman's database will be persistent between restarts. Next, we map port 8000 from within the container to port 7912 on our Raspberry Pi. This port is what you'll use to access Spoolman's web interface. Next, we define our one and only environment variable. This sets the time zone that will be used by the Spoolman container on your Raspberry Pi. You'll want to replace our placeholder text here with a TZ identifier. If you don't know what your TZ identifier is, we'll leave a link in the description below where you can find it. For our example, we will be using Australia/Hobart. Once you are done, save and quit by pressing Ctrl plus X, then Y, and then Enter. At this point, all we need to do to get Spoolman up and running on our Raspberry Pi is to write docker space compose space up space hyphen D. It should only take a minute or two for Spoolman to be up and running on your Raspberry Pi. Once you see that the container is now being marked as started, we can move on to accessing its web interface. To access the web interface, you will need to know the IP address of your Raspberry Pi. One of the easiest ways to get your local IP address is by using the command hostname space hyphen capital I and pressing enter. From our example, you can see that our IP address is 192.168.0.32. Now, open up your favorite web browser and go to the address http://, followed by the IP address of your Raspberry Pi, then the colon symbol, and then the port 7912, and then press enter. You will now be greeted with Spoolman's dashboard. With this, you can immediately begin to add additional spools and individual filaments to your inventory. Let us start by adding our first spool by clicking the plus symbol under the spool header. On this screen, you can see the numerous different options that Spoolman allows you to set. This includes the first use date, the last use date, as well as different information such as the price. The price can be incredibly useful for gauging how much a project is actually costing you to print. Let us show you how Spoolman works by creating an initial example spool. We'll start by setting our first use date to the 25th of January and the last use date to the 27th. Next up, we can set the filament type that this is. One of the really neat things about Spoolman is that it has a really great database of filaments. So all you need to do is type in the brand name followed by the type of filament that it is, and you should be able to find the exact filament that you have purchased. In our example, this is the Bamboo Lab Black PLA. This will set up some initial information for us, such as the initial weight, how much the package weighs without anything in it, and more. This interface also lets you set how much of the total weight you've already used. One of the easiest ways to calculate this is to weigh the spool and then subtract the empty weight value from it. In our case, we weighed ours and worked out that we had already used 520 grams. You can also select a location. This is super useful if you have multiple places where you store your filament. In our case, we keep some of ours in our laundry, so that's what we're going to set for this one. Once we are sure we have everything configured, all we need to do is click the Save and Add button at the bottom of the page. With that done, we have successfully added our first managed spool to Spoolman. If we open up the sidebar and switch to the Spools page, we can see that this filament is now listed here. Hopefully at this point, you will also have Spoolman up and running on your Raspberry Pi. If you like this guide, be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe for more. Until next time, have a good one.